except fried chicken in Malaysia. So when we ate Nando's, it was so spicy that we really, really fell in love with it. And the fact that it was healthy grilled as well. So that's what we fell in love with, the fact that you can sweat, the fact that you can have as much sauce. We're one brand that never ever tells any of our customers to stop using sauce. We encourage you to use as much sauce. So that's really what got us.
Excellent. This is first-hand information. Thank you very much, Ms. McGillan. 20 years ago, this brand has come here. I was having a chat with Chumin earlier, and she said she was merely a student studying in London at the time, in the UK at the time, and she tasted Nando's for the first time and brought it here. So from London all the way to Kuala Lumpur, 20 fantastic years. Thank you very much again for those very kind words. Okay, remember, you're the guys who made this possible, so join us in singing a very happy birthday to Nando's on the count of three. One, two, three.
But I have nothing against Singapore. I know Nando's is here, Nando's is in Singapore as well. I have nothing against Singapore. You know, Malaysia, Singapore, we have this common rivalry, right? My friends always say, Singapore kiasu, Singapore kiasu. I honestly believe Singapore is a very, very fine country. This is my honest opinion. Singapore is a very fine country. Because everything you do in Singapore, sure gonna fine. Have you been to Singapore? People who have been to Singapore, make some noise for me. You know this, right? In Singapore, everything you do, you can kena fine. If you eat in the MRT, you kena fine. You simply lalu lintas, you kena fine. If you talk on the street, suddenly once lighter come out, somebody will come give you a fine. Now, as a Malaysian boy, I was so paranoid because in Malaysia, we don't have much fines, right? Everything we can story away. But, But what I'm saying is, as a Malaysian boy, I was so paranoid when I went to Singapore because everything was so fine there. I met this beautiful Singaporean girl. I said, hello, how are you? She said, I'm fine. I asked first, how much the fine? Better make sure. But I am proud to be Malaysian. How many of you are proud to be Malaysians? Make some noise. Great. Now, I am proud to be Malaysian because I believe, Malaysian, we are so innovative and inventive. We conquer the world of language. Okay, now I prove to you. My favorite language is actually Bahasa Malaysia. I will ask a question, I want you to answer honestly. If your favorite language is Bahasa Malaysia, if your favorite language is Bahasa Malaysia, clap. Honest. Okay, see? Only a few. Let me change your mind. Okay, my friend, let me change your mind. My favorite language is Bahasa Malaysia because sometimes in Bahasa Malaysia, you don't even have to say a single word. You can tell a long story. Now, I repeat, kadang-kadang dalam Bahasa Malaysia, tak payah sebut satu perkataan, kita boleh buat cerita yang panjang. I prove to you, this usually happens when two makcik, dua orang makcik terserempak di pasar pagi. Makcik Amina is here, makcik Zaitun is there. Amina will start. Zaitun will be like, Amina. Zaitun. What is that? Tak ada perkataan. Isn't that fantastic? So my friends here, I know some of you BM Goya cannot pakai. But here's my advice to you. Anytime someone speaks to you in Malay, you just answer I know you want to eat chicken. I know I'm asking a lot from you because I ask you to keep quiet, listen to me. It's a very big ask. But here's my promise to you. Okay? I promise you, I just need a little bit of your attention because I won't take up much of your time. As you all know, young Chinese boys, we finish very fast one. So you just tahan with me, can or not? Now, I need your help. My job is very simple. To explain my job, I am here to tell you jokes. And if I tell you a funny joke, I need your support. I need you to clap and cheer if you enjoy the joke. Can we do that or not? Can I? Okay. Blow. Joe, haven't come out. We practice one time. I count to three. Everybody clap and cheer as loud as you can, okay? 1, 2, 3. Alright, okay. Now we start. Look, I am very honored to be hired to perform at this 20th anniversary. But I want to share something. Like, you all here as a guest, you don't know this. You know this, but I am an entertainer. When I am hired here, the clients will always ask me, can you mention the brand? I am not that kind of comedian, okay? I don't sell out. I am here to tell you jokes only because I take my job seriously, okay? I take my job very, 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 very seriously. So there will be no mention of the brand, not even twice, not even once, there will be none of those. You hear me? There will be Nando's. Oh, thank you. A bit delayed, but I'm glad you appreciate the joke. Thank you very much. Okay, we talk about simple things. Malaysian lifestyle. Now, ladies and gentlemen, clap if you agree. Malaysians, we love to eat. Agree or not? Great. Now, I believe Malaysians, we are the only nation who will plan for supper while having dinner. We will always tell me, I know you are not saying this, but half of you are thinking, how do I tapau some of this free chicken back for supper later? If that is you, please clap quietly. Don't let people see who clapped. Okay, see, got people clap, but we cannot see the hands. Because we know Malaysians, we like to eat. However, my friends, there is one country that will always challenge us when it comes to food. What is that country? Singapore, correct. Now, before I continue, I must ask, are there any Singaporeans hiding among us?
No!
The ones saying no them now must conclude Singapore that one. But it's okay, no. I have to ask, are there any Singaporeans hiding among us? Because the face same, but the attitude very different, huh? But no, I have nothing against Singapore. I know Nando is here, Nando is in Singapore as well. I have nothing against Singapore. You know, Malaysia, Singapore, we have this common rivalry, right? My friends always say, Singapore kiasu. I honestly believe Singapore is a very, very fine country. This is my honest opinion. Singapore is a very fine country. Because everything you do in Singapore, sure gonna fine. Have you been to Singapore? People who have been to Singapore, make some noise for me. You know this, right? In Singapore, everything you do, you can kena fine. If you eat in the MRT, you kena fine. You simply lalu lintas, you kena fine. If you talk on the street, suddenly one slider come out, somebody will come give you a fine. Now, as a Malaysian boy, I was so paranoid because in Malaysia, we don't have much fines, right? Everything we can story away. But, But what I'm saying is, as a Malaysian boy, I was so paranoid when I went to Singapore because everything was so fine there. I met this beautiful Singaporean girl. I said, hello, how are you? She said, I'm fine. I asked her how much the fine. Better make sure. But I am proud to be Malaysian. How many of you are proud to be Malaysians? Make some noise. Great. Now, I am proud to be Malaysian because I believe, Malaysian, we are so innovative and inventive. We conquer the world of language. Okay, now I prove to you. My favorite language is actually Bahasa Malaysia. I will ask a question, I want you to answer honestly. If your favorite language is Bahasa Malaysia, clap. Honest. Okay, see? Only a few. Let me change your mind. Okay, my friend, let me change your mind. My favorite language is Bahasa Malaysia because sometimes in Bahasa Malaysia, you don't even have to say a single word. You can tell a long story. Now, I repeat, kadang-kadang dalam Bahasa Malaysia, tak payah sebut satu perkataan, kita boleh buat cerita yang panjang. I prove to you, this usually happens when two makcik, dua orang makcik terserempak di pasar pagi. Makcik Aminah is here, makcik Zaitun is there. Aminah will start. Zaitun will be like, Aminah. Zaitun. What is that? So my friends here, I know some of you BN Koya cannot pakai. But here's my advice to you. Anytime someone speaks to you in Malay, you just answer or oh.
Ayam is new, right? Hello. Thank you.